Hey guys, Jake from 8020 Media here. Been having an issue on the Miata with the front brake pads sticking to the caliper. Figured while I go ahead and address and fix this issue, I'll go ahead and make a video talking about why your brake pads might be sticking, some of the problems that that can cause on your vehicle, as well as walk you through a couple diagnostic steps to figure out what's causing it and how to fix it. This is a big brake kit that I installed on here, and ever since I installed it, I've been having an issue with the brake pads sticking to the caliper. So if you listen closely as I spin it, you can hear the brake rotor rubbing up against the brake pads on the inside. This is a problem that we want to address for a couple reasons. First of all, as the rotor sits there and spins against the pads, it's going to wear down your rotor more quickly, and it's also going to wear down your brake pads more quickly. This is an expensive big brake kit, and so I don't want to have to replace these rotors or these pads any sooner than I have to. Fixing this is good to go ahead and increase the lifespan of these components here. And then in addition to that, when you think about it, as the wheel spins now, it now has resistance against it, which is going to create a number of performance-related issues. And more importantly, one of the things that it does is it actually creates additional drag on your transmission, which can be bad for your transmission in the long run. And then lastly, one of the problems that this also can cause is issues with your wheel bearing and other components around here. As these are rubbing up against each other, they're creating heat. And so what it can do is cause a bit of overheating around your rotor and your whole wheel, which can eventually lead to issues with your wheel bearing. Fixing this is important to minimize the number of maintenance costs that you have with respect to your brakes and your wheel bearings going forwards. If you do have this issue, one of the most notable signs is going to be the sound of the rotor rubbing up against the brake pads. In addition to the noise that this is going to make, you might also notice that your car is pulling to one side if you have a stuck caliper specifically on one side and not on both sides. Also, when you let off of the gas pedal, you might notice that your car is coming to a stop a little bit more quickly than it should be. And depending on how badly the brake pad is sticking, you might have issues with smoke and a smell coming through the cabin, caused from all of the friction and heat that's being created from these rubbing against each other. So that's the general overview on what a sticking brake pad or sticking brake caliper is, some of the problems that it can cause, as well as some of the symptoms that are going to cause it. So now we're gonna go ahead and jump into the three main things that can cause this issue. But first, before we jump into that, it's helpful to understand how a brake caliper works. And so we're gonna go ahead and show you the basics of a brake caliper so that then you might have a better understanding of what potentially is causing this problem. Now, this is an upgraded big brake kit here. This brake caliper is a little bit different than you're going to see on your typical cars. This is a four piston performance caliper, and so it looks a little bit different. So what I went ahead and did is I pulled the rear wheel off and I pulled the rear caliper off so that we can go back there and show you what a normal brake caliper looks like. All right, so this is a standard brake caliper right here. It's very small on this car because the Miata is very small. This is a standard one piston brake caliper. The first thing to talk about here is the number of pistons. So you have a piston right here, and what happens when you push the brakes is brake fluid is going to come through the brake line right here, and it is going to cause the piston to protrude outwards. And as that piston pulls outwards, the brake pad is going to go ahead and come forwards and make contact with the brake rotor. So this has the standard single piston here. We've got the brake pads right here in the middle that wrap around your caliper. And then another thing to talk about is the sliders on it. What you'll see with these big long things right here, these are sliders. As that piston comes outwards, this whole part of the caliper is going to slide with it to go ahead and make contact here. When you push the brakes, brake fluid comes through here. It's gonna go ahead and push the brake pads up against the caliper. And then when you release it, the piston's gonna slide back inwards and the brake fluid is gonna travel back up the line back to the brake fluid reservoir. And that's basically the process of how a brake caliper works. We're gonna come back to this here in a second. We're gonna go ahead and start with what some of the easiest or most simple to look into causes might be with why your brake calipers are sticking. Back to the front of the car, one of the most common causes can be having too much brake fluid in your brake fluid reservoir. What happens is as your brake rotors wear down, they get a little bit thinner. And as your brake pads wear down, they get thinner as well, which means that the piston and the calipers have to travel further to actually hug around the rotor to stop the car. That requires more brake fluid to be pumped into the brake calipers to allow the pistons to contract that much. If you just had a brake job done or you're just about to do it, if your brake pads are very thin and your rotors are old, you might look at your brake fluid reservoir, which is right up here in the front, attached to your brake master cylinder. You might look at it and notice that it's very low on brake fluid. So every brake fluid reservoir is gonna have a minimum level and a maximum level on it. As I mentioned, as your pads wear down and the rotors wear down, it's going to require more brake fluid to be sent into the brake caliper pistons, which then can make it look like it's actually low. However, once you put new brake pads in that are a lot thicker and you put new rotors in that are thicker as well, you're not going to require as much brake fluid. And so the level in the reservoir is actually going to go back upwards. So one common mistake is looking at it, seeing that it's low, and putting more brake fluid into the reservoir. And then what happens is you're either way over your maximum level here, there's too much pressure within the system, and the brake calipers are not able to be able to send that brake fluid back up the brake lines and into the reservoir here. So that's the easiest first thing to check, is make sure you don't have too much brake fluid in here. The second problem is specifically with the brake master cylinder. The brake master cylinder sits right here. It's on the driver's side of the vehicle. It'll have the brake fluid reservoir attached to it, but it is this component right here. As you look at it, there's a number of areas where you can develop leaks and have brake fluid leaking out of it. Having leaking brake fluid in your master cylinder or having a bad seal or some type of issue with your master cylinder can cause your brakes to stick as well. Inspect the brake master cylinder. Make sure you don't see any brake fluid dripping anywhere from it, and make sure visually you don't notice any issues with it. That's probably gonna be one of the more common causes of this if it's not having too much brake fluid in here. And then the last problem is going to be specifically with the calipers itself. So let's go ahead and go back to the rear caliper here and talk about a couple issues that can go wrong with it. With the caliper itself, we have our piston and we have our sliders. Each of these is covered by a protective boot. And so you can see this rubber protective boot here that protects the slider on both sides. What can happen is this boot can tear down, develop a hole in it, and then you can get water, dirt, grime in there, which can prevent the slider from being able to move back and forth to actually close up the brake pads onto the rotor. Same thing with the piston here. The piston also has a boot on it. And if that boot goes bad, you can get dirt in there, which will then prevent the piston from being able to slide in and outwards easily, which can cause issues with the sticking. If you have a problem with the caliper specifically, you're gonna have to go ahead and replace the whole caliper to get the problem fixed. Fortunately, on some cars, this might be very expensive. On others like this Miata, since it's a relatively small caliper, it's not super expensive. But this is probably a worst case situation, having to replace the whole brake caliper. The last thing to mention is that you might have improperly bled the brakes. You usually don't have to bleed the brakes if you're just replacing the brake pads and the rotor. Because your brake lines are gonna stay intact and attached to the caliper, you're usually able to just slide the new pads in and put the new rotor on there. However, the reason my brakes are sticking is because as I did the big brake kit, I had to pull all of the old calipers off. I had to drain all of the brake fluid and put the new brake lines in there. And so I started with a completely dry system and then had to fill up brake fluid in it, and air gets stuck in the brake lines. And air being in the brake lines is one of the biggest causes of the stuck brakes if you've just recently done something that might allow air to get into it. Now, alongside a brake job, you should always bleed your brakes. What that means is get all of the air out of the lines so that when you put your foot on the brake, there's only fluid traveling into the pistons and into the caliper, and there's no air in the system. Typical one piston or two piston brake calipers like this are just going to have one simple bleed screw here. The process for doing it, we're not going to cover in this video. You can find another DIY online, but basically you're going to open up this valve. You're going to have someone inside pressing the brake and trying to bleed all of the air out of it through this valve right here. So a one piston caliper is going to have one bleed screw. And then when we look at the four piston up front, this is a lot more complicated because you have four pistons. You have four pistons that you have to bleed air out of. There's one right here on the top. There's one on the bottom. And then there's another on the top and the bottom on the backside. These are a little bit more challenging to actually bleed, which is why I'm thinking that this is what went wrong when I went ahead and did this brake job. I'm gonna go ahead and bleed all of the calipers on the front, and hopefully that's going to fix the issues with my sticking brake pads. Anyways, guys, I hope this video was helpful. Just to recap, check your brake fluid, check for leaks in your master cylinder, look for any visual signs of damage to the boots on the brake caliper, and then make sure your brakes are bled and that you don't have any air in your system. That wraps it up for sticking brakes and sticking calipers. If you have noise coming from your brakes and you don't know what it is, check out our other video that talks about noises coming from your braking system, as we cover different types of noises and things that can cause those specific noises to help you diagnose why you might have a squeaking, a rattling, or a buzzing noise coming from your brakes.